One of the first stories about blasphemy we did was the passage and some of the background of the Defamation Act of 2009. Can you give us a little bit of a history of how that went from your perspective?
Well, the Irish Constitution has a clause in it saying that blasphemy is an offence which will be punishable in accordance with law. That constitution was passed in 1937, and it's a very Roman Catholic constitution. It includes, for example, a clause that says that the state acknowledges that the homage of public worship is due to Almighty God, which, if you think about it, wow, is not even enshrining the right of citizens to worship a god in the Constitution. It's enshrining the right of the god to be worshipped into the Constitution.
Wow.
So we have a very bizarre Constitution. That clause about blasphemy was reflected in law in a Defamation Act from the 1960s. And recently that Defamation Act was being updated. And the courts had found that the existing blasphemy provision in it was impossible to judge upon because it didn't define what the offence consisted of. So everybody assumed that in the new Defamation Act, that the blasphemy section would just be dropped. Instead, a new blasphemy definition was included in the new Act, and we became the first country in the 21st century to pass a new blasphemy law.
We've read that the blasphemy in this law is defined as matter that is grossly abusive or insulting in relation to matters held sacred by any religion, thereby causing outrage among a substantial number of the adherents of that religion. Is that actually a threat, and has anybody been prosecuted under it?
Nobody has been prosecuted yet. On the day that the law became active, Atheist Ireland published 25 blasphemous statements on our website, and our intention was to challenge the law on day one. If we had been prosecuted, we would have challenged the constitutionality of that law under other provisions of the Constitution. If, as we suspected was the case, we would not be prosecuted, it strengthens the political argument for removing the law, because if they're not going to implement it, then it's just bringing the legislature into disrepute. There's also a big danger with that law internationally, is that over the past decade or more, the Islamic states at the United Nations have been trying to make blasphemy and defamation of religion a crime internationally. And the moment the Irish law was passed, they leapt on that and suddenly started citing the wording, or part of the wording, of the Irish law as what they saw as best practice to be implemented internationally. And you kind of know when you're being cited by Pakistan at the United Nations as best practice for blasphemy laws that you're doing something wrong.
Wow, yeah, it was really shocking to see how many of the sort of blasphemy offenses happen in Pakistan.
Now, I understand that nobody has been prosecuted under the blasphemy laws, but anytime, especially if there's an update in the new century of how blasphemy laws are going to be enacted, has there been any chilling effects on free speech? Has there been any effects of this law being passed?
Well, certainly when I have been interviewed on radio and television shows about it, I have been asked beforehand by producers, make sure you don't say anything blasphemous. So I mean, it's genuinely, it does have that effect on people, even though it's an absurd law. Like, it's absurd and dangerous at the same time.
Now look, no one is to stone anyone until I blow this whistle. Do you understand? Even, and I want to make this absolutely clear, even if they do say Jehovah.